Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 750, and today's topic is the medicinal uses of Dhatura alkaloids. And this Dhatura plant is having long history, and the name Dhatura is Indian, and it is a Sanskrit word, and the Dhatura means it is thorny white apple, and the fruit outside they call it thorny apple, but in Sanskrit Dhatura means the thorny white apple. And actually Dhatura is having lot of religious importance. The reason is that it is their belief, because in India we have multi goddess system, Lakshmi, Shiva, Shankar, and Parvati, all these goddesses. So actually what they are saying, that it is Shiva who used to smoke Dhatura, and that's why wherever there is a Shiva temple, they put this Dhatura fruit in the temple, just as a sacred fruit. That's why it is called Dhatura. And this Dhatura is rich in alkaloids, and the same alkaloids, that is tropane alkaloids, where the pyrrole and pyridine nucleus is there. And in this pyridine nucleus, I have already given all the structures of propane or tropane alkaloids, where the nitrogen will contain methyl group, and mainly hyoscyamine and hosamine. These two alkaloids are there, and mainly it is this one, that is hyoscine, and hyoscine is 90% in the Dhatura, and hyoscyamine is only 10%. Actually, most of the Dhatura alkaloid is hosine, and here you have seen here that nitrogen in these two bicycle is having methyl group. That is actually the structure of tropane alkaloid, that where nitrogen will contain methyl group, the same thing here. And the second one, that is here also, the nitrogen is containing methyl group, and that is hyoscyamine alkaloid. And these alkaloids are very powerful anti-inflammatory. So Dhatura is very powerful anti-inflammatory, and also it is having sedative effect, hallucinating effect. And also in Indian, I remember when I was a student in high school, in poetry it was there, kanak kanak desoguni ya khai baura ya pai. Our Hindi teacher was telling that kanak means either gold or Dhatura. So both are dangerous. Either you will eat, once you are eating Dhatura, you will be having sedation, you will become abnormal. Or if you get sona, that is gold, you will become abnormal. So this is a very good, in poetry also, ya khai baurayana, ya pai baurayana. So that is the reference of Dhatura is there. And Dhatura, I have already told you that the word is derived from Sanskrit. It means the holy fruit, thorny, white apple type. And the goddess Shiva was smoking it. That's why in temple they keep it. And it is widely used as a sedative, and in also respiratory, bronchial problem. Also, it is having mild laxative effect. That's why it is used in constipation. And also, it is a mild painkiller. And that's why they are using it for muscles relaxation and muscle spasm. And of course, the people sometimes they also smoke it, and sometimes they chew it, but it is toxic and it has a strong effect on your central nervous system, and that's why it can have the hallucinating effect, and sometimes it can also disbalance our neurochemistry, that is production of dopamine and serotonin in the brain. And overall, it is not advisable to just take Dhatura leaf extract or fruit or any part of the plant, because it is having toxic effect, unless the expert in natural product or traditional medicine, unless they advise, because in Ayurvedic system and in Yoni system of Indian medicine, it is mentioned as toxic, and it is used for some particular purpose, not for like belladonna or other cocaine alkaloid. They are all propane alkaloids. So, Dhatura, because of the presence of tropine or propane alkaloids, where nitrogen contains methyl group, is powerful anti-inflammatory, and it is also used in stomach disorder if there is pain because of worm, it is used, and also it is used in lot of religious functions. So the medicinal uses of Dhatura alkaloids, and the botanical name is Dhatura stramonium, and it belongs to family Solanaceae number 1. Dhatura is well known Indian folklore medicinal herb, and the seeds of Dhatura are energetic, enthalmintic and anti-inflammatory, and they are used in the treatment of stomach and intestinal pain that results from the worm. So if you have any intestinal or stomach pain, and that is because of the worm, so the Dhatura seeds are used, and it is having very powerful enthalmintic and analgesic effect that result from the worm. And this plant is both poisonous as well as medicinal. Number 2, toothache and fever from inflammation is treated by Dhatura. If you have some problem in your tooth, and also because of inflammation, if you have some fever, some high temperature, it is treated with Dhatura seeds, and the juice of its fruit is applied to the scalp of the hair to treat dandruff. It is also widely used in remote area villages. The extract they will put to the scalp of the hair to remove the dandruff from the hair, and also they are using to check the falling of the hair. Number 3, it contains tropine alkaloid. Tropine alkaloid means where nitrogen is having CH3, that is called NCH3 grouping, nitromethyl group in the alkaloid, and that those two structures I have already given in the beginning. They are the main alkaloid of Dhatura. One is 90%, that is pyrrolidine and pyrrole 5-member ring, bicyclic with nitrogen attached with linked with, we can say, methyl group. And the second one is that is 10%. So in this way, these two alkaloids are there, and their structures are given in the beginning, and they are called tropine alkaloids, or some in references they also call it tropane alkaloid, because tropane is that 5-member ring on the basis of that, wherever in alkaloids that tropane ring is there, such alkaloids are called tropane alkaloids. And it contains tannin, carbohydrate, protein, the propane alkaloid which contain NCH3 methylated nitrogen grouping. This NCH3 methylated nitrogen grouping is the main grouping of propane alkaloids, and it includes the anticholinergic drugs, and that is called atropine and scopolamine. From ancient civilization, they are using it, and it was traditionally used for religious visionary purposes throughout the world, and used by witchcraft in medieval Europe. So, Dhatura is an Indian plant, and the whole plant is widely used in Indian system of treatment. And in India, actually, it is mainly used for two purposes. One, it is a powerful anti-inflammatory. So that's why wherever there is inflammation, swelling, burn, it is used. And secondly, it is central respiratory nervous system, central nervous system stimulant, and also it is very good for our respiratory system, in the sense that if there is decongestion starting from chest to nose and you have the problem of nose breathing, it is given. And in this way, nowadays the latest publications show that if there is congestion, nose blockage, means we are not able properly to breathe from nose, is a serious issue. And as we know that only two possibilities are there for our breathing, either by nose or by mouth. So if there is congestion because of some allergy or because of some inflammation, and we are not able to breath from nose, in that condition, this Dhatura plant powder is given, and it is harmful. You know, you should not think that by any way, once we are receiving the air and oxygen, even either by nose or by mouth, is same. No, if you are receiving air from mouth and your nose is congested because of allergy or because of inflammation, it is harmful. The oxygen level will be down in your body because your nose works as a filter of the air, and it protects from a lot of other bacteria. So that's why this Dhatura plant powder is used to decongest your nose. It is used as a central nervous system stimulant because of the presence of tropane alkaloids, where the methyl group is attached to nitrogen. That is the group of alkaloids. They are very important from medicinal point of view and from hallucinating point of view. That's why Dhatura is medicine as well as poison if it is taken in excess. For example, in America, in one research publication, it is given that in 2000 year, some adolescent children, they became ill because of the overuse of Dhatura seed. So it should be used only by expert and experienced local doctors who are expert in traditional or herbal medicine. So number four, the Indian god. That I have already told you, the Indian god Lord Shiva was known to smoke Dhatura. This is, in literature it is mentioned that Indian, one of the goddess named Lord Shiva, he was smoking Dhatura. So that's why in Shiva temples, they put this Dhatura fruit, that is thorny white apple. And the word Dhatura
is derived from Sanskrit. It is purely Indian Sanskrit name, Dhatura. Known to smoke Dhatura in India, people still provide the small thrown apple during festivals in Shiva temples. Dhatura is a Sanskrit name meaning white thrown people. Number five, an extract made from leaves is taken orally for treatment of asthma and sinus infection. That is same the congestion. Asthma and sinus condition means all these pores are blocked because of allergy. So in that case it is taken so that the congestion is clear and there is decongestion, which is very important. Infections and bark powder are applied externally to treat swelling, burns and ulcer. That is all I have already told you. Some incidents of poisoning cases were reported in USA in 2000s, mostly among adolescents becoming seriously ill from ingesting Dhatura seeds. Number six, the most important medicinal usage of Dhatura plant is plant in India is its anti-inflammatory property of all parts of the plant. It is also having central nervous system stimulant effect, and it has respiratory decongestion effect that I have already given the explanation. It is used in the treatment of dental and skin infections. So, with this, I will stop, and the Dhatura alkaloids are over. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.